Hydrox, I'm ballin' out, but I ain't never had the J's in school. I dropped out to make a better way, I flipped a few. They said pressure is the only way to get the juice.
Hey y'all, it's Below the Trap Angel. I just dropped my mixtape and I'm here with Vereen TV. He's here asking me questions, whatever y'all wanna know. I guess y'all already got the questions together. But yeah, I'm just here to answer whatever y'all wanna know about me. B-Lo.
So what's up, B-Lo?
Well, I'm here. We out in Miami right now, but here for the 2K pool party, and like I'm posting it because my mixtape just dropped. I need y'all to go copy it. It's right now. It's only for sale. It's available on iTunes, Spotify, what else? Google Play. What else? I don't know. But yeah, I know when I was dropping it, I was going through, like this is my first project. So this is my first time knowing how it go. But just know, it's just gonna keep coming. It's gonna keep coming faster and faster because that was my first project. And I need y'all to copy it though. So y'all can get an understanding of what y'all gonna get from fucking with me. But yeah.
So you wanna be labeled as a rapper or a singer?
Rapper. Yeah, I think I don't sing at all. I sing because I'm just vibing or whatever. Like, you know, my voice be flowing. I would say I'm a flower.
Yeah, because I know some female artists, we call them rappers.
Flower.
They get offended when you call them rappers.
No, I'm a rapper. Yeah. I'm a rapper. Yeah, I'm a rapper. But it's just like, you know, I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't compare myself to what everybody knows female rappers to be, you know. So my sound is unique. So just like he asked, like, am I singing or rapping? I mean, just like you asked.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Who am I talking to? Okay, just like you asked if I'm singing or rapping, I feel like that just shows that it's own little thing, you know. My style is just its own little style. It's not really something that you can compare to somebody else's. Okay.
So who inspired you? Someone in the industry right now, who inspired you?
Gucci Mane.
Gucci Mane?
Yeah.
And female artists?
Oh, female artists?
Yeah.
Inspiring? I don't think any female artists inspired me, but they do motivate me. Because if I see, like, okay, a girl, you know, in that situation can get in another situation, that might be how I look at my situation, you feel me? But, like, I wouldn't say really there was a specific female artist that inspired me.
So it's no one that made you want to become a rapper?
No.
That you was growing up, who did you?
It probably was that made me want to just be a rapper. It wasn't nobody. It was just life.
There's something
it was. It was college wasn't working out because I had to pay for college, so that wasn't working out. So I just changed my life. So I guess you could say I dropped out to be a rapper. Whatever.
And what your parents have to say about that? Whatever.
They're like, oh. Okay, be safe in Atlanta. Yeah.
So, okay. So what made you move to Atlanta?
Music.
Music?
Yeah. I never even told y'all where I'm from. I'm from Palm Beach. I'm from Palm Beach. I just moved to Atlanta like 6-7 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's still new to me, but I like Atlanta. It's just a lot of people doing the same thing.
Yeah.
And I linked up with like my team, my people, like we're loyal to each other, you feel me? But like still at the same time we go and we meet people who could contribute to like what we got going, the motion of like we trying to keep a motion and momentum going. And I feel like in Atlanta it has that momentum that I'd be looking for. Like I'm always like on go, you know. So Atlanta has good momentum. That's how I know.
So you saying probably Atlanta support?
You said what?
Atlanta support more than Palm Beach.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying Atlanta Atlanta is good for work. Not, I can't
it's
can't
much
really
easier
say.
Or something?
Nah, I mean, I guess it's much easier. I guess because it's more of a bigger city.
Yeah.
So bigger cities, they got more money. Mm-hmm. You feel me? And like, you could just, it's just easier to get your money in a place like that. And like, that's probably one of the factors, like financial stuff that I, that other than like, you know, since I cut off school, it's like, I'm focused fully on this music stuff. Okay. So like, in Atlanta, it's really accessible to me. Like, whatever I need is really accessible. I can get more work done, I feel like, in Atlanta.
So explain the making of our truck, Angel. How long did it take you to make it?
Well, it's weird because half the songs I made the month I dropped it, you feel me? And the other half was just like songs here and there. Because I just started rapping this year. Not this year, yeah. Not 2018.
17.
But yeah, within a year. So I then started rapping. So like basically, I had pieces of songs here and there, like, oh, I wrote a song before I decided, okay, I'm gonna actually go behind a mic. I had like ideas and stuff.
Yeah.
So like, it was songs from here and there. Probably Griselda was a song I made that song way back in summer. But like, you know, it was just like knowing how to be in the game and being guided and putting music out and actually getting taking advantage of your work,
yeah,
and not letting other people take advantage of your work. That was like what, you know, made it have a weight, you know. Like, even though I made the song in summer, I could have been dropped it, but it's like I have to work, so I have to build something, I have to make something. So I knew like, okay, hold on to these here and there. And then like when I have like a bunch of songs that I've been making, but like when I was really deciding, okay, we gonna put this project out, it was right after we built our studio.
Yeah.
So we have our own studio now, and you know, that's the start of our label.
What's the name of the label?
Safe House. Yeah, because we, you know, we always just in the house, like in the trap house, and like everybody come to the spot. Like, it's a house studio, but at the same time, it's very like built up and professional. Like, we invested, we went from nothing to something, you feel me? And now it's gonna be even more something. You know, we keep this momentum. So I feel like the project, I had an idea. Okay, I gotta figure out, like, how are these people gonna look at me as? And then I decided, okay, shit, I'm the, like I said, Gucci inspired me. He's a trap god.
Yeah.
I'm a trap angel. But I'm not gonna say, I'm not trying to, you know, be Gucci. I don't sound like him at all or sound like a girl version of him at all.
Yeah.
I just love how he moved, the way he handles shit. And like, you know, at this point, like, he done went to jail and then still on top of everything. And like, I feel like that's how I need a grind, you feel me? So that's a good inspiration, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like women don't have to only look at how other women took a route. Cause I ain't gonna strip, I ain't gonna get a boyfriend in the industry, you feel me? That's not, like, I feel like I don't even gotta be compared to the female rappers at all. So then, finally, just dropped it. But I set the date, like, when I was like, okay, everything's happening right now in Miami. I'm going to be down there. I'm going to get my music out because, like, I'm just starting. I know, like, I got to really promote my own shit. I'm really sending my songs to everybody in my DMs for real. Like,
yeah.
So it's not like I'm just doing it for fun. I'm really just working. So.
So how long does it take you to make a song?
I would say a day, but like, it could be like less than a day. It could be like 4 hours, you know what I'm saying? But like, if I get the beat, okay, I'm gonna do this. I might find the hook first, like vibe with the hook first, and then like, I don't know, if I'm still feeling it, I'm gonna just finish it, like write it right then and there.
Yeah.
or punching, whatever. And then I'ma just do that. But if, sometimes it'd be like, I'm not even feeling this no more. And then I'll like go back. I'm like, okay, wait, actually I'ma make that something. And then I might go write the song out and then come back to the studio, record it. So basically, it could take a day, 3 to 4 hours, 5, 6 hours.
Okay. Is there any female in the industry you want to work with?
Oh yeah, I work with anyone. Names? I work with anyone. I don't have any names right now, but I work with any of them.
Anyone?
They just gotta hit me up. I mean, there's some girls from Palm Beach, Bougie. I'm Bougie. There's some girls from Atlanta, Essence. There's some girls, you know, there's some girls like, you know, we in the, you know, I ain't looking to just, oh yeah, I want to do, like, it's nobody that I really.
But they got to reach out to you first?
Yeah, it's no one, no, they don't got to reach out to me first. It just got to be in the moment, like, okay, let's do it. Okay, let's do it. I'm not going to go out my way for that. If somebody hit me up and they paying me, and I'm like, hell yeah, I'm gonna go out my way. I'm gonna make sure I handle that shit and I'm gonna get my check. But there's no girls that I'm like, oh shit, I wanna. No.
Okay. So what do you think for an artist to make it? Which one of these you think is the most important? The clout, the money, or the talent?
Honestly, nowadays, I feel like it depends on what you mean by make it. Because some people might see, oh shit, they made it, they doing something. But that person not seeing none of their checks, you feel me? So it depends on what you mean by make it. But for a artist to get in a position
what they wanna be,
where the majority wants to be, they just gotta be better than the next. So whether it has to do with clout, okay, that person getting all the attention, what you gonna do? You feel me? When it has to do with money, okay, that person grinding got money, or that person still living their mama house and, you know, they doing their rapper shit. Okay, that's fine. Let them do that. And what are you gonna do with your situation? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So really, I can only say it's like, you just gotta play the game, because it's like, it's a competition. At the end of the day, it's a competition, because it's not for everybody, but everybody want it. So yeah.
So what make you different from other female artists? What do you think?
Other female artists? Well, I feel like a lot of female artists, like, they're just another version of something that has already been done. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, someone coming out sounding like Nicki Minaj, looking like Nicki Minaj, you know? Or they're inspired to do music because they look like Nicki Minaj, okay?
Yeah.
Or something like that. And I feel like that's none of the reasons. Like, it wasn't nobody I wanted to sound like. You know what I'm saying? I didn't even think I was gonna be a rapper until I dropped out of school.
Yeah.
Because whatever I'm focused on it. You know what I'm saying? I fucking always had above 3.5 GPA. You know what I'm saying? I was always focused on whatever it is I'm focused on. So, but I always loved music. I was never in the studio, none of that. But I was studying business, planning on building a studio, running a business, building a production company is what I always wanted to start.
Production company?
That's why I went to school for business, a production company, period. So, like, and then I just realized, okay, I'm gonna do all that. Fuck. Why don't I just make music? Fuck. Why don't I just be a rapper? You know? So, I just always thought I couldn't be a rapper because I always been shy. I always been quiet. I hate scenes with a bunch of people. I come because I have to. You feel me? I don't go to the club to hang out. Not because I don't like the club, but because I don't like all them people. I go to the club and I work at the bar, and I'm behind the bar and nobody touched me, and I don't even have to feel nobody. So I'm really like anti-social. I can say I'm anti-social, yeah. like, yeah.
So you think that's good for the industry, antisocial? Or
I feel like that. I feel like it's okay for the industry because at the end of the day, the industry sees what you give them. Yeah. So they don't gotta know I'm antisocial. They don't gotta know that I don't want to be standing right here right now. Yeah. That this is awkward for me. But I don't want to be standing here. I'm saying like they don't know. You just gotta play your role. So like that's how I would say I would deal with being antisocial. But I am working out of it. I was just saying like that's why I never thought I would be. I would never told myself okay you should rap. So yeah. That's why I'm just getting into it. Because I was always shy and antisocial, just here for, all people knew was what they saw, even because I was so antisocial, like, you know, but shit.
So, to make a song, what are some of the main things you need in the studio?
Main things?
You know, some people need weed, they need liquor, lean.
I be telling myself I need weed, but I be telling myself I don't. But still, I like when weed's there. And weed make my voice is soft anyways, and like that's the sound that I do. It's like I have a soft voice. And weed just be like making it feel it's straight. You know?
Yeah.
I be not wanting to have it, but yeah, weed. And shit, not too many people. I don't like too many people.
So just you and a producer?
No, it could be like people. It could be a couple people. Like where I record, niggas be in and out, you feel me? People be in and out for real, just trying to handle some shit.
So what's next?
What's next? Well, if these videographers stop playing with the kid, see. That's what I mean by nobody know me. So all they know is what they see.
Yeah.
People don't take me serious. You feel me? That's another reason why it took me a long time to get this project out. You feel me? I having to go get everything I need. People don't be taking a cute girl serious at all. Period. Like, you feel me? I'm not even getting into details about it, but like I'm trying to give y'all some real work for real. Like I've been working, I got a couple videos. Waiting on a couple videos I'm planning on shooting, and then I'm already working on finishing up the next project. This is only the first. Just know.
Trout Angel 2? Or are you gonna call it something else?
I might call it something else. I don't know. I don't know exactly what I might call it, you know? I gotta think right now and give it a name. Shit. I'm a y'all gonna see it when it drops though. I don't know exactly though.
So what's your favorite song from the tape?
My favorite song? I think it's Emo because as soon as it come on, I'm just like, I'm dancing, I'm doing every dance I can think of because it's definitely lit and vibing. Emo. I like Griselda a lot. I like, I would say Snatch Your Bitch. I like that one a lot. It's a vibe. Shit. Money Horny. All my ladies were like that. Like, when I was trying to feel who I wanted to relate to, I was just going in about female shit. So I can't really recommend niggas. Damn, I'm just going through the whole fucking tape. Shit, Emo my favorite though.
Emo?
Yeah.
So that's the one that's gonna shoot a video for first, or?
Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
I'm trying to shoot it within a few days.
Okay.
Yeah. Soon.
So you wanna close it up?
It's up to you. What else you wanna know? Shit. I'm from Palm Beach, I'm 20. Nah, I'm not even gonna do that. I'm not gonna say nothing. Y'all need to know. Go get that Trap Angel. It's below. Checking out with Green TV. It was a pleasure being here and letting y'all know what I'm here for and what y'all need to look out for. And all all that shit. But yeah, shout out Palm Beach 561. Shout out the Ivory. Shout out AK. Shout out With Waters. Shout out my team. Shout out my family. Shout out shit. TT. I don't know. Shit. Follow me at BELEAUX. It's pronounced below, but that's how I spell it. And that's on everything. Social media. I mean, Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram. I don't got Facebook. They disabled me.
I'm falling out, but I ain't never had the J's in school. I dropped out to make a better way, I flipped the fuel. They said pressure is the only way to get the jewel. I'm putting pressure on these niggas cause they fucking fools. April fools if I don't do what I say I do. Fuck a runner, I'm a boss, but I run up on you. And I'm counting up cause there ain't nothing else to do. FOE, I don't give a fuck about the rest of you. Spend a check or two, go and spend a check or two. Make that money move, make your pockets bad blue. And a jab blue, a star like the capital. I need all my coins, I don't like to get rational. Like they off a perk, my haters so emotional. Live your best life and they take that shit personal. I ain't checking for him unless he got a work or so. Phone stay dry, my trap phone going down. Step out with the ice, milk shades don't melt. You know I keep that fire strap like a seatbelt. Niggas gon' talk and bitches gon' hate, yeah. I'm just getting guap, cannot relate, yeah. Spend a check or two, go and spend a check or two. Make that money move, make your pockets bad blue.